is Jessica Garson, and I'm a developer advocate on Twitter. In this video, I'll be talking about one of my favorite endpoints, recent search. Recent search allows you to get public tweets from the past 7 days based on a query that you define. You can use recent search combined with tweet sentiment to see which tweets based on a given query were the most positive or the most negative, or to track changes week by week with a visualization. By combining both native Twitter API tools and a third-party sentiment solution, I recently created a code sample to create a weekly sentiment score for myself. Before you can use the V2 version of the Twitter API, you will need to create a project and an app inside of a project. Projects allow you to effectively organize your work based on how you intend to use the Twitter API, so you can effectively manage your access to the API and monitor your usage. Each project contains an app with which you can generate the credentials required to use the Twitter API. I have a project called Video with an app inside the project called Sentiment Video. Whenever I'm building on the Twitter API, I like to have the docs handy to reference as I go. I'll show you where you can find these docs. In the developer portal, if you go to the section of the side navigation bar entitled Products and clicking where it says Twitter API, you will get taken to a page where you can see all of the available V2 endpoints. If you click next to where it says Recent Search, where it says Details, a card on the right side will appear that contains a link to documentation and other helpful resources, such as rules and caps for this endpoint. If you click where it says Introduction, you will get taken to the main overview page for recent search. From here, you can find other helpful resources such as the API reference guide and a migration guide that might be helpful as you build. We're all ready to go now, so let's get to the code. Today, I'm going to show you an example of how to perform sentiment analysis using Python, Microsoft Azure, and Twitter's recent search endpoint on your own tweets. You can learn more about how to get started with Azure by reviewing their documentation on the subject. I'll be using Twitter's early access to the V2 version of the Twitter API to assign a sentiment score to each tweet from the past 7 days. Using the text editor of your choosing, you can set up your configuration file called config.yaml. You will want to set this up to replace the X's, as I have in my example, with your own bearer token and subscription key for Azure. You can obtain your bearer token for the Twitter API from the dashboard of the developer portal. You will need to pip install request, PyYAML, and pandas first in your terminal. Requests will be used to make HTTP requests to the Twitter and Azure endpoints. And pandas, which is used to shape the data you'll be working with. PyYAML allows you to parse the .yaml file where you'll be storing your keys and tokens. You'll need to import these packages and the packages for JSON and AST, which are part of the standard library of Python, so you don't need to install them ahead of time. You will use JSON for parsing the JSON from requests and AST to help you with some data wrangling. Additionally, you will import pandas using the alias PD, so you don't have to type the full word pandas each time you want to call the library. Before you can connect to the Twitter API, you'll need to set up the URL to ensure it has the right field so you get the right data back. You'll first need to create a function called createTwitterURL. In this function, you will declare a variable for your handle. You can replace Jessica Garson with your own handle and format the URL with tweet fields to shape which fields get returned. For this example, we'll be using the field lang for language. The max results can be anywhere from 1 to 100. If you are using a handle that would have more than 100 tweets in a given week, you may want to build in some logic to handle pagination or use a library that has support built in. Keep in mind that the early access version of recent search has a 500k tweet per a month activity cap, but we likely won't be getting anywhere near that with our basic searches like this one. You'll return a formatted URL in a variable called URL since you'll need it to make a GET request later. To work with your secrets, you can now create a function that allows you to retrieve the data from your config file called process.yaml. In the function createBearerToken, you can get the bearer token from the section called SearchTweetsAPI. You can also create a function called connectToAzure, which allows you to pass your credentials into the URL you'll be using for your request. To pass your subscription key into the right format for the header needed to connect to Azure, you can create a function called Azure Header. To connect to the Twitter API, you'll create a function called Twitter Auth and Connect, where you'll format the headers to pass in your bearer token and URL. At this point, this is where you connect to the Twitter API by using the request package to make a GET request. From here, we can create a function called Twitter Auth and Connect. So we want to put the definition. So we want to call this Twitter Auth and Connect. And then from here, we want to pass in the variables that we've defined earlier. So bearer token and our URL. And so from here, what we're going to want to do is now create a variable for headers. And then we want to set that inside of a dictionary. So from here, we're going to want to set a space for the key and for the value. And so the key is going to be authorization. And the value is going to be bearer. And we're going to use string formatting to pass our bearer token in here. So we're going to do dot format and then bearer token. And then from here, we're going to want to set another variable inside of this function called response, and then we're going to want to set this as request.request, and then from here we want this to be a get request, so we're going to want to specify that, and then pass in our URL, and then we want the headers to equal the headers we just defined in the above variable, and then from here we could just return the response.json. In order to get your data into the correct format needed to make a request to Azure, you can create a function called createDocumentFormat. The output of this would have the word documents in front of the JSON payload for the Twitter API. You can now create a function to make a post request to Azure sentiment endpoint and return the JSON payload containing sentiment scores. So from here, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to define a function of sentiment scores. And from here, we want to pass in the parameters of headers, sentiment, URL, and document format. And then from here, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to set the response as equal to request. And then from here, we're going to want to use the post function, so request.post. And then we want to pass in our sentiment URL and the headers we've created. And then from here, the next line, we actually need to add in the JSON, and we want to put that into the document format. And then from here on the next line, now we can actually return our response.json. This code sample also contains some additional logic to combine the sentiment scores into the data frame you've used so far to create a score for your tweets and to categorize the score as positive, negative, or neutral. There is also a main function as well. To run your code, you can now go to the terminal and type Python 3 sentiment.py, and we can now see the JSON payload that contains the sentiment scores for our tweets and a categorization of the past week. This code could easily be extended to let you know which tweets were the most positive or the most negative of the week, or to track changes week by week with a visualization. In addition to performing sentiment analysis on tweets, you can also use recent search to perform workflow triggers. For example, when a user tweets X, from there Y happens. Let us know on the forums if you run into any troubles along the way, or tweet at us at TwitterDev if this inspires you to create anything. Thanks and have a great day.
Follow us at TwitterDev and on the community forums.